The Austrian Grand Prix was another race where rain was forecast, but never actually came. Nevertheless, it was still a relatively entertaining one, with Norris fighting the Mercedes and some great battles going on in the midfield. But up front, it was a no contest, as Max Verstappen cruised to his fifth victory of the season. So, without further ado, let's dive into the winners and losers from the Austrian Grand Prix. Winner, Max Verstappen. If you were to describe Verstappen's race in one word, what word would you use? Let me go first. How about perfection? Pole, led every lap, and the fastest lap. It doesn't get any better than that. Max became the first driver on the grid to secure a Grand Slam victory in 2021, helping him extend his lead in the championship to 32 points, more than a full race win over Lewis Hamilton. He was never really under threat from anyone behind all race long, and he even had a large enough buffer to make another stop with 10 laps to go to secure that extra point. Max's form this year has been simply stunning. He's maintained his record of finishing either first or second in every race he's completed. He looks calm and composed in the car and is consistently getting the most out of it. After qualifying, he was actually somewhat disappointed with his final run in Q3, which I think just goes to show how hungry he is to keep finding areas of improvement. Joining Verstappen on the podium was Honda Technical Director Toyoharu Tanabe, who was also on the podium at the same event 2 years ago. And I think a shout out needs to go to the Japanese manufacturers for their growth over the years, as well as their role in powering Red Bull to race wins. I've actually been spending quite a bit of time making a video on their journey as an engine manufacturer, so be sure to keep your eyes out for it, hopefully tomorrow. But yeah, another superb drive from Max Verstappen, who only seems to be growing even stronger. Loser, Sergio Perez. On one side of the Red Bull garage was triumph, but on the other side was disappointment. Checo's performance today was pretty poor, considering how well he's done in the last few races, and it all started with that lap 4 incident with Lando Norris after the safety car came into the pits. Now, I'll get onto my thoughts about the incident a bit later, but it no doubt set him back a lot in his efforts to secure a Red Bull 1-2. He would drop down to as low as P10, but managed to fight his way back through the midfield. On lap 41, Charles Leclerc made a move around the outside at turn 4, much in the same way that Checo tried to do on Norris in the opening few laps. However, the result ended up being the same, with the Mexican running Leclerc onto the gravel and receiving a 5-second time penalty. He would then do the same again at turn 6 and get another time penalty for not leaving a car's width. This meant that even though Checo crossed the line in 5th, he was classified in 6th behind Carlos Sainz. To me, it felt like Sergio was a bit too frustrated by that incident early in the race, and as a result, we saw him being more ruthless when it came to defending from Leclerc. But ultimately, he only ended up hurting himself, especially because he did it on 2 occasions. Had it been just the one, he would have been classified in 5th. Given that he also started in P3, he should have achieved a lot more than he did. Winner, Lando Norris. At the start of the weekend, Lando said in an interview that he was confident he could give Max Verstappen a run for his money in the same car. Well, evidently, he didn't even need the Red Bull to get close to beating the Dutchman and backing up that claim. So far, I'd say that those two have been the stars of the season. In Norris's case, he has overachieved on certain occasions, such as putting his McLaren on the front row and missing out on pole by just 0.05 of a second. His initial reaction from the line was slightly quicker than Verstappen's, but he didn't have the pace in the second phase to make the pass. Behind him was the other Red Bull of Sergio Perez, who tried every trick in the book to sneak into P2. But Lando came through with some brilliant defensive driving before the safety car came out. Once the track was clear and racing resumed, Checo was again all over the back of the McLaren. But this time, he ended up in the gravel when attempting an overtake at turn 4. Personally, I don't feel Norris deserved to be penalised for this, as he was simply holding the racing line. But at the same time, Checo was alongside through the corner, and arguably was entitled to a car's width instead of having to take to the gravel. Nevertheless, Lando recovered exceptionally well to finish in 3rd behind Verstappen and Bottas in what was the 4th podium of his career. As I've said on numerous occasions, he has hit a completely new level this year, and it's great to see him continue to rise. His defense today was what impressed me the most, as he was under threat from Hamilton for quite some time, but still managed to keep him at bay. When Lewis eventually got past, he praised the McLaren driver over the radio by saying, quotes, "He is such a great driver. Coming from a 7-time world champion, that definitely must have meant a lot." Loser, Esteban Ocon. For the fourth race in a row now, Esteban has either retired or finished P14 on a Sunday. It just hasn't been coming together for him lately, as he was unable to make it out of Q1 during qualifying. His race lasted no longer than 3 corners, as he found himself sandwiched between Mick Schumacher and Antonio Giovinazzi. He made contact with the Italian's left rear tire, instantly breaking his front suspension. Ever since signing that 3-year contract extension with Alpine, things seem to have gone downhill for him. On his day, Esteban can be really quick, but at the moment, he's going through a bit of a bad spell. He'll need to find his feet again as soon as possible, because his teammate Fernando Alonso is starting to feel a lot more comfortable and is only gaining more confidence by accumulating more points than him. Hopefully he'll have some better luck next time out in Silverstone to regain some momentum. Winner, Carlos Sainz. It's fair to say that the Spaniard was pretty off the radar for the first half of the race, but it was during that period where he was making the most progress. Sainz was promoted to start P10 after Sebastian Vettel was handed a 3-place grid drop, but crucially had free choice on tyres given he didn't make it into Q3. Ferrari decided to put him on hards for the first stint, which lasted until lap 48. From there, they fitted the mediums, and Carlos went on attack mode till the end to cross the line in P6, but as a result of Checo's time penalties, he was promoted to P5. You know, one thing I think we underestimated was the quality of Sainz and Norris as a driver pairing. Not just in terms of how well they work together, but in terms of how fast they really were. Sainz right now is giving Leclerc a run for his money at Ferrari, and we all thought Ricciardo would come into McLaren and show Lando who's boss. So far, they have surprised a lot of people, but it just goes to show that they are world-class talents. Only 2 points separate Sainz and Leclerc in the Drivers' Championship, so I wouldn't completely rule out the Spaniard potentially finishing ahead of his teammates come the end of the season. Loser, Yuki Tsunoda. Yuki put himself in a great position to score some solid points by qualifying in P7. But since he started the race on soft tyres, he wasn't able to go as long on the first stint and ended up being the first driver to make a scheduled pit stop. On the entry into the pit lane, he went slightly over the white line and earned himself a 5-second penalty. Now, it would have been understandable for him to make that mistake the first time around. But then, on lap 51, he went and did it again and got another 5-second time penalty for the same incident. I mean, come on man, you can't be making the same mistake twice in a row. Let's just say that Yuki won't be having a fun time talking to Helmut Marko afterwards. Winner, Valtteri Bottas. Finishing second was probably the best case scenario for the Finn. The most eventful part of his race was just after the safety car came into the pits, where he briefly passed Hamilton for P3. But the Brit fought his way back past before the end of lap 4. After that, he simply inherited a place from his teammates who suffered damage and another place from Norris who was given a penalty. However, he was still there to pick up the pieces for Mercedes with Checo down in the midfield, so I'd say that his race was solid. This was also his highest finishing position of the year, so he can hopefully gain a bit more confidence moving forward. Given all the speculation surrounding his seats, I think he made a small statement with that performance as he bagged some strong points for the constructors at a track where Mercedes just seemed to lack a lot of pace. Who were your winners and losers from the Austrian Grand Prix? Be sure to leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel if you're new to enjoy my latest videos in the future. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.